Hey, y'all, it's Woody Overton, the host of Real Life, Real Crime, the podcast, and you're listening to Local Leaders, the podcast.
So we got two guys here that if you're in Denham Springs, and especially if you have a child or children that go to Denham High School and you attend football games, you've seen them in the parking lot. If you ain't seen them, you've heard them. There's no doubt about it. They are rocking and rolling and having a good time right there in front of Jacket Stadium. And y'all go ahead and introduce yourselves.
I'm Ricky Foster with the Dads of Denham.
And I'm Dan Bourgeois from the Dads of Denham.
And he has a perfect voice. We were talking about that before the podcast, but I got a little meter here, and every time he talks, it shoots right up, which is what you want. Very good. Your voice is good, too, though. I'm not leaving you out.
Yeah, he was.
Man.
Talk to Johnny Cash right here.
He's just really good. Yeah. So to tell y'all how these guys came to be sitting in front of me right now is I was somewhat familiar with them only from afar, right? So I would go to the games. And I would hear some great music, a lot of it from back in my generation, which was really nice. And I'm like, where's that coming from? You see these big trucks with lights all over them, and it's the Dads of Denham, and they're partying, having a good time over there, and supporting children that are, I don't know if you call them young adults, I guess, right there at Denham Springs.
17, 18 year olds.
Yeah.
Let's call them future adults.
Yeah, that's right. Don't give them too much leeway there.
Future, yeah, that's the best way to put it.
But it's funny when you have kids that are around that age, it's like they're always kids to us, even though they, you know, at 18, they're adults, but they're kids to.
They will always be kids to me.
That's right. Period. Period. So I guess my first question for y'all, and this is a question I had when I first saw y'all for the first time getting out of my vehicle, and that was, how did the Dads of Denham come to fruition? How did it start? Was this just one guy's idea and he recruited friends, or how did that start?
Here we go,
son.
So we was at the golf, so on a Tuesday. Again, Coach Beard calls me. It was during COVID.
Yeah.
Okay. He calls me and says, Rick, you want to play golf? I said, sure, I'm off on Tuesdays. So we got together and we met up at the Denham Springs Country Club. It's called the Pines now.
Paul's
bought it. Yeah. So we went over there and we was like, well, look, we'll play a quick, because you could go there and play 18 holes in an hour and a half.
Yeah. Right. No doubt.
So we went there and we was playing golf, and Coach says, Ricky, don't you cook? And I said, I do. I said, I cook jambalaya and pasta lot. He said, look, I had some guys from my old school. They used to cook for me, you know, for the kids.
Yeah.
Do you mind doing some pregame meals? I said, no. I said, but if I'm going to bring a pot. So when you go to cook like this, you're going to have a tent because sure. It gets hot.
Yeah.
You got your pot. You got everything out there. You're going to play a little music because it ain't like you can cook and it's done in 15 minutes. It's a two-hour process,
no
you know,
doubt.
3 hours.
Absolutely.
So I said, look, if I'm going to bring all this out there and cook, do you mind if we just tailgate, you know, after we're done and everything's set up for the boys to eat pregame meal?
Yeah.
He said, no problem. And so I said, well, I'm going to get together a group of guys, and we'll tailgate together, kind of like an LSU theme.
Right? Absolutely.
Mean theme.
Yeah.
When you go out to Tiger Stadium and you walk past tailgate after tailgate, it's just a good time, right?
Yes.
There's nothing wrong with it. It's just a good time.
Agreed.
Well, I said, well, we're going to get a group of guys together. So I met one of the other parents. He introduced me to Dan. And me and Dan just started recruiting people, right? Yeah. And so we recruited people, and we got to our first it was against – who did we play? It was
Woodlawn.
Woodlawn opening. Was our first cook that we did.
Yeah.
And we had to feed Woodlawn, and we had to feed our boys after the game.
Oh, that's awesome.
So we ended up cooking 300 plates that day, and they loved it.
Yeah.
So even the coaches called Coach after it was over and said, hey, man, we love the food. Thank you, you know, for cooking for us. And it just took off from there. That's how, I mean, it just started from a golf game again.
Yeah.
And once he gave us to go to cook, if I'm going to set it all up, we're going to tailgate.
Right.
Right? We're going to enjoy the entire atmosphere of a football game like you should. And that's what we do in South Louisiana.
That's exactly right. Mm-hmm. And it's interesting, guys, that is the feeling that I got when I saw that for the first time. It's like when you're walking in front of Tiger Stadium, you see all the tents up, you know, there's people everywhere. And one thing that's good about South Louisiana boys and gals is the fact that we'll share some food. We ain't got no problem. That's right.
I tell you what, we have fed, let's see, we did 8 games. I think it was 8 total, right? We cooked 200 bowls per game. So 1,600 bowls was given away free from the Dads of Denham.
Wow. That's awesome. I mean, that really is a big deal. Yeah, it's a lot of work, too. And, I mean, I know y'all probably – I mean, I'm sure you look at it as work. It is work, but there's a heart involved, right? Well,
it's work to cook, right? Anything you do is work. If you want something – I mean, if you're going to do anything, it's work to do. Well, that right there is just it's a blessing to do it for us.
Yeah.
It's something that we get – it's a good feeling. You know, when it's Friday night and the game's over and the parking lot's gone, we're cleaning up. Then we all go to my house because that's where we store everything.
Yeah.
We clean everything. I mean, the game may be over at 10:30, but Dad's Denim ain't done till 1.
Yeah.
Because we got to put all this up.
Yeah. You're no different than the football team, the band, and everybody else after the game, they're still doing things. I know the band. I have 3 kids that were in band. One of them graduated this year, but I still got 2 rocking. And it's amazing to me how that game ends at 10. And my wife, who does a lot with the band, don't show up at home till almost 1 o'clock with the kids.
Correct. And
we divide the duties out too. Right. So cleaning, stirring, mixing, whatever. So it's not just a one man where everybody else sits.
No, it ain't just me and Dan doing it all. Yeah. You know, everyone comes to my house. We load up.
Yeah.
We go together. We set up. You come back to my house. We do it together. And then the night's done.
Yeah.
Right,
yeah.
But back to your point of giving food away, if you're in South Louisiana and you cook in a pot that feeds 200 people and you don't give it away, shame on you.
Yeah, you can't freeze it all, right?
No, you can't keep it. It's not, if you're cooking 200 plates, I mean, and that's what I want everyone to understand coming into this year, too. It's free. Come
yeah. eat. Yeah, and you know, here, I believe it was Dan. I have walked, I go to all the games, and I walked out of the car, and I believe it was Dan that approached me, and he said, "Hey, man, you want some jambalaya?" You might have been doing pastelaya that day. Y'all ever do pastelaya?
Well, yeah.
Well, okay.
A mix. Yeah.
It might have been pastelaya you offered, and at first I was like, no. You know, you almost, if you don't know the people, right. You almost feel like it wouldn't be right for me to partake. They're just being polite. Right. That's kind of like the mental attitude. Well, let me tell you, I took about 5 steps, and then I saw somebody else's plate, and I was like, you know what? I think I'm going to take you up on that.
Double back.
Get me a plate. Yeah. I didn't care at that point. I was like, I got to get some. And incidentally, unbelievably good.
It is good.
So not only is it free, but it's good. Well, and
I will tell you this, I learned from the best. John Jenkins in Santa Maria, Louisiana, my father-in-law.
Yes.
He taught me
everything.
And it's funny because I'm going to tell you a little secret. A lot of people don't know this, but they can help me do everything. They stir.
We know what he's going to.
You know
what
I'm saying?
Oh, yeah. Know where you're headed.
They helped me. They. I've taught them all. I mean, Dan cooked a pot just Saturday night by himself.
Graduation party.
Because he's learned how to do it, right? When you cook it so many times. But I'm going to tell you a secret. No one knows the ingredients but me. That's the kicker, see?
The season.
The season. That's what I mean. The season. Yeah. No one knows the seasoning. So they'll call me. Rick, I'm going to pick up the food today. What's the seasoning? Nah, I mix it myself. Look, it's funny because that's what you don't tell, right?
Yes.
So my father-in-law gave it to me. He said, don't ever give it away. Yeah. Nobody can ever make it like that.
Yeah.
So, and that's one thing. Even these guys, 8 of them, with the other 7. Rick, what is it? Mm-mm, I ain't telling. Yeah. That dude, hey, he's 6'6" and about 300 pounds. I'm not giving his recipe away.
It's an excellent, I wouldn't. It's an excellent season mix, but I want to add to that what I called Ricky. My son graduated this year as well, so we had this party at the place, and I was going to cook a pastelaya. So I put everything. I called Ricky. I said, hey, I need a pot for 200. Ricky said, Dan, I got the pot. I got the paddle. I got the meat all called from Carter's to get it all cut up, done. I got the season mixed. I got a brand-new gas bottle.
Yeah.
Now, you know, normally when a buddy tells you, I got something, here's a pot.
Yeah.
This man just put it all together.
Eat a man.
Yeah, and whatever.
I like that.
Yeah, and what everybody kept saying, man, this is awesome pasta line. I said, hey, I can't take full credit.
Now, see, that's the difference between me and him. I'd be like, you dang right it is. It's well, a whole family recipe.
Go ahead and get you three bowls. Go ahead and get you three bowls. I did good.
But then I'd have to do it next time without him. And, you know, I don't know.
Yeah, you get to buy him real quick on that.
But, hey, like I said, good, that's my brother forever now. Yeah. You know, and when he goes out there and does anything, even on his own, it's representing all eight of us.
Oh, yeah.
And I want, man, let's do it right every time.
110%.
But that's the way we are. Nobody steps up. Mm-mm. We call each other different. He's prime time. I'm the counselor for the old guy, you know, keeping straight. But we love it because nobody steps in front of everybody.
Mm-mm. Right.
We walk up as dads. We're dads. It's not this dude and then four behind him or whatever the number is.
I love that, man. Never. Yeah, man. Y'all are a team. Y'all are your own team.
That's it. You know? That's it.
That's right.
One team, baby.
You take talk about one team. I had to work the Saturday of the spring game.
Mm-hmm.
And shout out to Mudbug and LLC right here in Denham. They gave away six sacks crawfish to us. They gave us six sacks. We bought all six. I had to work. I couldn't be there. These guys handled it. I mean, I'm not the only one that can cook. These cats can cook.
Yeah.
You know, so, man, we do it as a team, and that's what's fun.
Fantastic.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, and shout out to Mudbuggins.
Yes. You know, man, great.
For their generosity.
Man, to give away six sacks of crawfish during crawfish season is strong.
Yes. You know? Yep. Yes. Now, tell us, you mentioned it, the nicknames. Tell us about the nicknames. How did that come around?
We were sitting around, and actually we were talking about T-shirts. And we were like, okay, what do we want to do here, you know? So Ricky, you know, drives up in that big old stretch he's got. So he's prime time.
Yes.
So that's prime time.
That's perfect for him.
So then me, the oldest guy, I'll do him about, Wes is right behind me at about 3 years back. So I'm counsel, right? So anytime they think of something, well, slow down, guys.
I tell you what. While we're going through the names, I'm going to tell you this. Let's walk down. Dan is the counselor, and I'm being 100% honest. I've never done one thing without asking him. I call Dan because you know what? That older person kind of brings you back down the way it used to be. No, and that's why he's the counselor. I mean, I call Dan, what you think about this? Rick, don't do that. You're gonna, and it helps you to realize what's going on. And so we have the counselor prime time.
Yeah. Big Wes.
Big Wes is the enforcer. I mean, look, he's got hands.
Big Wes is Big Wes.
Yeah.
You know, he's the one that's going to make sure no one gets to the dads of Denham. That's for sure.
Yeah.
Right.
Then we got DJB.
DJB, yeah.
We got the Ballers, which is Jeff and Jamie.
Jeff and Jamie, yeah.
Ballers. Yeah, they are baseball coaches.
Awesome.
So we call them the Ballers. And then we got the Gambler, right?
No, you got the – well, yeah, we changed that.
Yeah, the Gambler.
Okay, so half and half. Half and half is
the Gambler.
Okay. And then you got Mike. Mike's
the press. You know Mike Bartolucci?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
He takes all the pictures. He's part of this.
He's the press.
He's the press.
Awesome. You always need a good press guy. There's no doubt about it.
And look, and Mike, he's – man, one of the greatest guys Mike is. And it's funny because you don't see his face with the dads of Denham very much because he took the picture.
Yeah.
You know, he's behind the lens.
Perfect. Perfect. Well, y'all all and everybody has a strength, right?
There it is.
And you're kinda building off that strength, and kind of like a team atmosphere, you know, it's a lot like a football team.
That's right.
Everybody's got a role and something they're doing, whether it's stirring or cooking or
no matter
cleaning
what.
Or whatever.
Yeah. Keeping us all in line.
Keeping it yes. You know, it's funny, I used to work with a guy who was much older than me and not much, maybe 10 years, but he used to have this saying all the time. He would tell me wise things, and I would say, man, I never thought about that. And he'd say, learn from old people.
No, it's the truth. And you know what's
he didn't care. He's,
there it is.
Learn from old people. What's scary about that is I hope kids do that now, you know, their grandparents, because I know we learn from old people.
Oh, yeah.
And I see it going away, but that was a good point you made. Learn from old people.
Yeah. Not mature old people. We're just saying learn from old
I'm not
people.
There yet, but not I'm there yet.
Dan's old.
We'll have a 6-0 party in about 4 years. So,
you know, in researching you guys, your branding is interesting. tell me how that came up. And we're going to have some pictures that pop up while we're talking, because when I edit this thing, I'm going to make them pop up. And we'll show kind of the branding and stuff like that. Mike, tell me how.
Shout out to Mike Roussel again. Mike, I was watching a football game and text goes off, and it's a picture of the dads of the logo of the guy with the hat backwards, and it said Dads of Denham. And I immediately snapped a picture and I sent it to these guys, and they said, Heck no. We're not. We're not. Look, it got worse than heck no. But look, sometimes it's funny on this group message. If you could go to it and read some of the stuff on this group message, it's probably the funniest stuff you ever read.
Wow.
So normally it takes an hour for everyone to finally respond. I send that picture out. Look, all seven responded in 3 minutes. No, forget it. It looks like you. I said it doesn't look like me. So we got the logo and I put it up. I snapped it in my phone and I left it in there and we just went on with Dad's of Denim. And there you go. We was talking about shirts we was going to make. We're going to put the counselor on the back. Well, what are we putting on the front? With Dads of Denim? I said, let's use the logo. This is a month or two later. And I said, let's use the logo. And it's like, whatever, dude. Just if you got to use this logo, use it. And we did, and look what happened.
Yeah.
It's bada bing, bada boom.
Yeah.
It worked.
It is. It's an eye catcher. And it's probably perfect for y'all's personality. Even the mic drop part is just perfect for you.
I don't even want to tell you how the mic drop got on there, and I'm not going to tell you.
Don't do it, man.
Just remember the mic drop.
The mic drop.
Yeah, there's a story behind that. Mark Roussel, thank you for the mic drop.
Yeah.
On part two, we'll get to the mic drop. I'll see if I can get it out of him. I'll pull a little Diane Sawyer on y'all.
There you go.
Yeah.
So, okay, you get out there, you start cooking, y'all are rocking and rolling. First of all, my question is, did you get any pushback?
Go fish.
Look, before I even finish that sentence, I could read.
Yeah. You see that?
Everything that was about to happen. Tell
him, Dan. Yeah. We know the play before the bat is swung, man. No, it was interesting to say the least. I mean, we were dealing with, concessions in the stadium. They were kind of concerned. We were dealing with the association, had their dinner sets and all that. So we did have a little bit of riff about us being there, kind of taken away.
Yeah.
So we did form a little meeting, and we brought in the association.
We did.
We told them, we said, hey, we're paying our $25 due.
Yeah.
So if you need us to help you raise for others, do it. But you're inside. This is an outside atmosphere. We're in the tailgate parking lot cooking. This is where you want to be. You don't want to go sit inside a building. You miss the atmosphere.
That's a good point. And look, that would be like LSU walking around telling people you can't cook outside Tiger Stadium.
Can you imagine them saying
because they sell food inside?
That's right.
If you want to tailgate, go inside the PMAC, please. No.
Yeah,
it's not going to happen.
That's right.
Your kids see you out there doing something in society, the social networking that you're doing.
Absolutely.
Or they see a building, and I think my dad's over there.
Yes.
So now there's eye-to-eye contact, but they're not right here on you. They're comfortable knowing we're there.
I agree. And
so the pushback, we receive pushback, and that's okay because it's over and done.
Sure.
Dads and Denim are here.
Yeah.
That's it. And we ain't going nowhere.
Mic
drop.
I'm starting to see where that came from.
No.
We're just giving you a little taste, but no, that's not it.
So, and my thought on that is you're doing something positive out there. And sometimes maybe it just takes communication and for people to understand where you're coming from and you to understand where they're coming from. That's right. And maybe somewhere in that it's like, oh, we can find some common ground, just like you did with the association. You met with them.
Yeah, you find that common ground because we're all going the same. We're going to the same finish line, but there's different ways you can get to that finish line.
Absolutely.
And if you all get to the same spot, and that's supporting children in Denham Springs High School.
About the kids. That's it.
I love it. Yeah, I can't argue with that at all. So eventually, you did kind of progress outside of sports, though. You started doing some other things. I know recently you did a car show.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, but you know what set us on the map? I thought about this when I was sitting in the truck because, I know questions are going to come, and you don't know what questions you're asking. I was talking to Dan on the way here. What can we talk about? What people forget is I think when we got big was the toy giveaway.
Yeah.
We gave away 400 toys the weekend before Christmas. We took over 800 pictures with Santa.
That's huge.
And we gave away 6 bikes and I think close to 100 basketballs, footballs, soccer balls.
Oh, yeah.
All right. And it was all donated to us. It was during COVID. People didn't want
it bothered me to see people posting pictures with Santa behind a plexiglass.
Yeah,
me so too. I told him in July I tested positive for COVID.
Yeah.
So I said, I had it, so let the kids sit on my lap. I dressed as Santa. The news people come. We got 20,000 views of that video that the news did. We gave away toys to kids, and they let them take a picture with Santa. That's when Dad's Addendum took off.
Yeah.
Right there. That was the moment
that,
you know what, these guys aren't about cooking and tailgating. They're about for these kids.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
It makes a lot of sense. And it's fun. You know, I was going to kind of talk about this part later, but now's really the perfect time. When I look for leaders, one thing I look for is, what are you doing to give back to your community?
Right.
No matter what it is, because all of us can lead in our field. And maybe if you're in the sales field, you're the top sales guy forever. And that's great. And you want to do that. But
let me look at the camera.
At the same token, you also want to lead in the way that you give back to others. I didn't learn that till I was much older. When I was younger, it was all about it. First. I want to be first. And I still want to be first. Don't get me wrong.
Ricky Bobby.
Yeah. But I want to be first. Definitely. If I was in the Dad's Addendum, y'all, that's what y'all call me. Not Ricky Bobby. Not
Ricky Bobby. You got it.
Want to be first, maybe. But
I want to thank 7 pounds, 8 ounce baby Jesus.
Yes. We definitely want to thank him. So on that subject, the importance of giving back is just as important as anything else you're doing in your life as far as being a leader.
That's right.
Some people figure it out earlier. I figured it out much later in life. I was probably close to 40. I'd give at my church. I'd do things like that. But I wasn't doing this stuff. I wasn't doing the extra. This, no matter what way you spin it, takes time. It takes a lot of time. It takes time away from just chilling on the couch or doing whatever you want to do on a weekend, maybe a Friday night or something like that. And as much as you want to do it and as pure as that is, there's a lot of dedication that goes into that. And so kudos to you. You guys are leaders just from that aspect, not even counting your professional lives, but your...
Well, that's what people, you know yeah.
Which... Number one, Ralph Sellers.
Yes. Y'all come see me at Ralph Sellers.
There you go.
No, but it takes a whole lot.
Yes,
it does. People don't see behind the scenes, Dan.
Mm-mm.
They don't see. No. They didn't see Sunday, or was it Sunday? Yeah, Sunday, you at my house, you done had to clean up everything, bring it back. You know, people don't see the behind the scenes of stuff.
Right.
And to put together that toy giveaway, it was 3 days before we did it. We had to work and get all the toys together to even, you know, and it takes way more work than people think.
Absolutely.
Right. And what you're saying is, what we're doing, you figured out at 40. Well, I'm 42 and I just figured it out.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And you're right. You I guess once you grow up, when you stop worrying about, let me do me, and you start doing for everything, you're
That's
blessed.
Right. That's right.
You do for other people and you get blessed.
Yeah, that's right.
100%.
Yeah.
100%.
I took it from my dad. My dad and mom. Dad's a hard-working brick mason, retired. Yeah. And he put us in that truck every summer. Yeah. And he says, come on, boys, we're going to work.
Yeah.
So you wanted to go back to school, but you were given. You wasn't, hey, I got, my friends are going to the beach. We're doing this. We're helping out the family. And that's where a lot, I'm the youngest of 4 boys.
Okay.
So you learn patience to wait on things. They'll come to you, but you got to work for them too.
Yeah.
They're not giving. And that's where I kind of learned at an early age. Plus, you know, I'm in the 60s. So,
yeah. Well, I tell you counseling. This.
The 1960s, not the 60 years. Okay?
If he's the youngest out of 4 boys, he can handle himself too.
No,
right?
No doubt.
Became the lead singer.
That's right.
We're going to change his name to Karate Kid.
Wash on.
That's right.
You know, but like you said, it's a blessing when you do for other people.
It really is.
Feels good.
And you find yourself. You find yourself.
That's right. And it's almost like you can't even repay people for what you learn out of those experiences.
That's right. That's it.
And that's what I love about it. Now, the obvious question for me or for the listeners out there probably as well is why? Why sacrifice all this time? The why is as important as the actual doing. And, you know, can you really put a thumb on why?
I would say, just to lead off on it, we all had kids playing on the football team. Mm-hmm. So, and then there again, I coached football from 85, going back in years.
Yeah.
And then came out here and
told
coached.
You he was old.
Yeah.
Coach Dan. Did they have helmets back then?
Yeah.
Well, they was leather.
The leather helmets. Yeah, man. We gave Crash Dummies a new name. But, no, to give back to that for our kids and for their friends, it just – it seemed like it was a calling for us to do it.
Yes.
You know, especially this day and time, kids are so easy to be pressured into doing other things. We give them that dad view, if you will, you know,
yeah.
that lead down the road from experience.
Yeah. Yes.
Our history, like we were saying, repeats itself. So when you kind of set the scenario of the end road that they could end up on, it gets them thinking at the front of the road.
That's right.
Right.
They see you doing it.
Yeah. Right? And then they start putting two and two together. I mean, that's what my dedication is.
Absolutely. It's doing it for kids that doesn't have that father figure.
Yeah.
You know, you ask what keeps us going is this, it's probably those messages we receive.
Mm-hmm.
I get messages all the time is, where can you help my son? Where's somewhere my son can go? You know, what type of programs is it out there for my kids? You know, that's what keeps you going.
It's huge.
Yeah.
It is.
And look, and, you know, it's kind of like the HIPAA law. You don't want to talk about people's problems, right?
Sure.
But when people come to you and want help, then what do?
That's right.
You help them.
You help,
right?
That's right.
And I guess that's that the Dad's a Denim logo is just be a father.
Yeah.
You know, to or help a child who doesn't have that father figure.
Yeah.
You know, we're not here to take away from a father's duties by no means.
Right. Right. Right.
But we don't leave that parking lot until every kid is gone.
Yeah.
We bring them home. I brought them home myself. Our fed.
Yeah.
You know why? Because some of those kids ain't going to go home to a hot meal.
Yeah.
So we'll feed them. If you're hungry, we'll feed you after the game. If you need a ride home, we'll bring you home.
Yeah.
That's what we do.
That's awesome. That's all I can say about that. Now, let me ask you, both of you, either one of you, away games. Do you see any other groups like yours at away games, or is this very special?
Santa Mall was probably the only one that had a tailgate.
The pit.
Look, you know, that's if you're going to go to a. Obviously, Texas is known for Friday Night Lights, right?
Yeah.
The movie's been made. I mean, they've made about 500 movies about Friday Night Lights, and if you're going to go watch a football game in Louisiana, Santa Mall.
Yeah.
On a Friday night.
There's no doubt about it.
That's the whole atmosphere.
It's rocking.
So
yeah.
I did the chains for Santa Mall, believe it or not.
Oh, really?
Yeah, my father-in-law to this day still does the chains for Santa Mall high school games. That? My mother-in-law runs their booth where they sell all their stuff, and she does the booster. She raises the money. So that's kind of who I talk to get this going.
Yeah.
Okay? Because they raise $1 million a year. Over there for their sports. So if you're going to go to a game in Louisiana, it's there. So when we went to Santa Mall, she gave us our own spot.
Right next to theirs.
Right next to theirs. And we tailgated together. And that's when we was like, hold on, man, we can do this.
Yeah.
Right? Then we go to other places. Some places says, get over here across the ditch and you can cook. Other places says, get off my property. I mean, we've had it all.
No kidding.
Oh, yeah, man.
Get out of here.
Here comes the logo.
All that music. No, it wasn't the music. It was that darn flag waving.
That flag waving will get you.
Yeah, that'll get you every time.
Every time. And do not eat their chicken.
Yeah.
If you're from Dumb Springs, don't go to Linda's and eat. They don't like you eating their chicken and waving a flag.
Who, Linda's?
Yeah, I'm joking.
That's some good chicken.
I'm joking. Yeah. It's the best chicken around. I'm playing.
Very good chicken. Now,
so we're going to other places, we it's fun. No, we don't see other groups.
But you'll welcome people to come up and eat some food. And
they'll come up.
They could be a Santa Mall Gator, and you're going to say, come on in. And
we've had a bunch of people at Assumption.
Yeah.
Wasn't it Assumption or?
No, Assumption. They moved us across by the cow pasture. Yeah, but
we had to go across the ditch.
Was it Zachary?
Across the ditch. Was it Zachary? Yeah, we did feed some people from Zachary. Yes, mm-hmm. We did Zachary. And it was somewhere else we went and fed some people, I thought.
Wow.
I don't remember. It was it's kind of a blur now.
Like last year. It is.
Yeah. Not me. I mean, it was so much going on with COVID and just
It was a lot. So we've done so much since those football games. Yeah. I'm ready to do football games.
Yeah. So y'all have a passion for football, I would imagine. Most it definitely. Goes back. You played, obviously. You
yes,
played.
Yes.
Big guy there. I played for Broadmoor Buccaneer, but it was in the good old days.
Glen Oaks Panthers.
93.
Baker Buffalo.
Woo. Look, some rivalries back in that. But look, Baker had some good teams now. Man, but
yeah. You know. Speaking of Glen Oaks, you know who I think about every time I hear Glen Oaks?
Yeah, I bet I can name it.
Who?
Gabe Northern.
No. Lester Earl dunked Gabe. On me.
Oh, Lester. Remember did?
Lester
oh,
Earl yeah. dunked on me.
Ugh.
That dude
Gabe's
was like
a good yeah.
He oh, was
yeah.
7 foot 12 in the sixth grade, Lester was.
Oh yeah.
Remember he went on to LSU in Kansas and
yeah.
then
yeah.
actually Lester Earl beat Kobe Bryant in the McDonald's All American dunk contest.
Oh, did wow. he really?
YouTube it. Lester Man, Earl beat Kobe really? Bryant. Really? Hey, we were supposed to play Glen Oaks this year. We not.
We wasn't ready.
Well, we was not ready to go to what is it, Olympia Stadium?
No, we're going to Glen Oaks
Memorial.
Man.
No, they got a stadium.
We got a stadium, bro.
Back in the day, they didn't have a baseball field or nothing over there.
Yeah, it was. That's right. And you know, it's interesting you brought up Gabe Northern. Very good guy. I know him mm-hmm. personally. Was a heck of an athlete in high school.
Still as big as he is now. He looks the
yeah,
same.
Yeah. Just but a great human being.
Yes.
Outside of that.
There's still really some good class, people out know. There.
Retired yeah. out of Buffalo, didn't he? Buffalo
yeah.
Bills.
Buffalo yeah. Bills was mm-hmm. his last team and he was an athlete, man. Even you know, high school was hitting. Who's your favorite pro teams? If y'all had to pick one.
Miami Dolphins.
Yeah.
1972.
Larry Zonka.
Larry Zonka.
Mercury Morris, Bob Greasy.
Yeah.
Believe it or not, mine was my favorite football team is the New England Patriots.
Snowplow team. The snowplow.
Hold on. You didn't even let me finish.
I'm sorry.
So New England Patriots, then the Saints, and that's it. Like, I'm not rooting for a Dolphin.
Yeah.
Fins up, baby.
Fins up. No, yeah, I'm always. Packers I'm gonna tell you why I become a New England Patriots fan when all the LSU people went there.
Yes,
bro, it was LSU North. Oh, up
Kevin
there.
Falk was going there. Every year they draft LSU. Well, because Nick Saban,
even
was
Rohan. I thought Rohan was gonna go
yeah,
to Miami.
Rohan Davey. Yeah. yeah.
Tell you a quick story. I'm good friends with Jarvis Green.
Yeah, okay?
we had him on our show. Our Heck little dad's player. A denim show. And
true shout story. Out to the dads that didn't.
Yeah.
Soon to be produced at my studio.
There you
hey,
go.
Hey. So Jarvis told me a quick story. He walked in to see Saban his senior year.
Yeah.
Jarvis had a yellow mohawk. Okay. And Saban says, son, you want to go to the NFL? He said, I do. Yes, sir. He said, well, you need to shave that mohawk off first. He shaved it off, had a heck of a year, made a phone call, Belichick. Draft him in, I think, the fourth round.
Mm-hmm.
Jarvis Green. True story.
No kidding.
Mm-hmm.
I'll tell you what, and that reminds me of a quick story. So I played for Rusty Price, which was no joke as a football coach. Head mm-hmm. coach for Broadmoor for many, many years and tough. One day, this is back when Brian Bosworth was real popular.
Yes,
are you kidding me? We're getting that. I had got a flat top like his. Now, I had hair at one point in life.
It does.
So I got this flat top, and I'll never forget. I'm walking through the hallway or whatever, and coach walks past me, and he stops. He looks over, and he says, let me ask you something. I said, what? He said, the girls like that? Oh, they love it. What are you talking about? He's like, no, they don't. He just kept walking. And so, yeah.
I got that haircut when complex. I was a kid. And it, you know what it was? It was a flat top with shave sides yes. with a mullet.
Yes.
Put all that together.
Yes. And bleach. You could bleach the top of it blonde like he did.
Yeah, so I had that haircut. And like I said, it was a train wreck if you had that on your head.
Oh, you had to have a bunch of mousse and all kinds of my stuff God, to make it, that thing work.
Flat top, shaved on the side, mullet in the back. Son, yeah. I'm ready.
See, yes. We had long hair for the leather helmets. You know, everything's good.
You
had
to have you padding. And Jim Thorpe.
That's right. You had to have the padding.
What about Jim Kelly? You know that dude. He never won a Super Bowl, did he?
Yep.
He went 47,000 times in a row and never won one. Who kept beating him? The 49ers?
That was the Bills against, I guess, 49ers, huh?
Yeah.
I'm just curious.
AFC.
Montana used to just light him up.
Oh, yeah.
And then, you know, another one was Marino. Marino never won a Super Bowl.
That was not a reason why I was a
prima donna, though. I wasn't a big Marino guy.
His best thing was he had Mark Clayton and Duper.
Yes.
Those receivers. He would just throw it up in a Hail Mary, and they would just get under it.
Yeah.
And
hey, that, it was definitely.
The Clayton and Duper show was definitely the 85s.
Yes.
You know, that
absolutely.
Time frame.
Yeah. Yeah. I was a Brett Favre guy. I just like him. He was a real football player, man.
I like Brett Favre.
The funniest thing, though, to bring it back around was New England Patriots. You know, they had that snowplow that knocked Marino out of the Super Bowl that year. So the guy came out with the snowplow and cleared off the extra point, and they kicked it. They won the game. So me coaching locally, Southside Patriots.
Yes.
I got so much flying Elvis in my closet from the Southside Patriots after being against New England. Yeah, it's just like, good.
Hey, he's a Patriot fan at heart.
You know I am. For Jarvis.
For Jarvis, that's right. Yes, yes. And I'll tell you what, they're winners. There's no doubt about that. I mean, they're some suckers. You know.
Now, what are they doing now?
Ooh, look where your win went.
Yeah.
Straight to Tampa.
Yeah. Bro, is that incredible what that cat's doing?
Yes,
it is. It's unbelievable. I mean,
he's 40, what, 40-ish?
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I'm 42. I can imagine getting out there with some 20-year-old studs.
But when you don't get hit like that, body's going
to
stay,
healthy.
Oh, yeah.
They pay for that line.
Yeah. Right.
I think I read somewhere he hadn't ate a cheeseburger in like 6 years. Can you imagine?
God. He's on the Giselle diet. What is going on with Tom Brady?
He said the Giselle
eat you some
diet.
Food, boy.
That's what I'm going to tell my wife. I was like, I need to get on a Giselle diet.
Giselle diet. Yeah, no cheeseburger. But I'll tell you, he's a winner everywhere he goes. There's no doubt. But we're going to get back to you guys. We could talk football all day.
All day.
Now, there's a lot of expense that goes into this, right? You give it out for free, but it ain't free, period. And I don't know, maybe some people donate some things to you, maybe not, but
never.
Well, we need to change that, folks.
We try to keep it
all
clean.
All you business owners I know that listen to my show, we need to, you know, you want to do something good, reach out and help these guys out a little bit. But interesting thing is y'all don't ask for anything.
Never.
That's right. That's right.
Never ask for a penny.
Yeah.
You know why?
Do you accept it if someone offered?
Never have.
Really?
Never accepted a penny. Because we felt like this when we first met, when we first sat down and we started this Dads and Denim.
Mm-hmm.
If you ever accept money from someone, you owe them forever.
Yeah. I've always felt, I hate owing people money.
That's it. Keep it clean.
It's not that I ever have to give them the money back. It's just the point of they can call and say, hey, I need you to do this, and you're going to feel that guilt of when they did donate $500 to us.
Remember when I gave you that rice? I need your vote.
That's right. That ain't happening. So this is a fun podcast.
Yeah, I like this, man.
But
say
am
it
I right? Are you right? Or I mean, am I right or wrong? That's the only reason.
Yeah.
The way we look at it, it's a minimal investment dollar-wise for us.
Yeah.
It's more the passion to do it, the food and all that stuff, it's there. But for what we donate per person in our group to tailgate, you divide that out by concessions and it balances out.
Yeah.
So it's not like we're putting in thousands of dollars.
Right.
Do you realize the cheapest thing in the world to cook is jambalaya?
Yeah.
And it goes the furthest.
Really?
Yeah.
How do you estimate that? So if you have 200 people, what do you figure like per person? How many pounds?
A dollar a person.
And
that's all it costs. It's $1 per person.
And how would you figure out how much you needed to cook?
I have that. We have that broken down.
A chart.
Yeah.
He's got it. I told him I need 200. Season was ready for 200.
Yeah. So that's
meat was ready. Onions were ready.
That's what I'd be nervous about was over or underestimating. With crawfish,
we did it for
5 pounds a person.
5 pounds, that's right.
Usually.
We cooked a pot for 500.
Yeah.
For the powerlifting meat.
That's
For the Joey Shoots, wasn't it?
The car show was what, 1,000?
1,000 for the car show.
That was a big pot.
Yeah.
That was what, 4 foot.
It was packed over there.
We'd all fit in it too. That pot.
Yeah,
all three of us could lay in it.
Hot tub.
Ball up.
As a denim hot tub.
So back to the money is we never accepted a penny, and we pay our own dues up front.
Yeah,
we have our yearly dues that cost to do the entire year.
Okay,
and we split it in 8x8. So it's not. It's so cheap.
Yeah. So y'all really have 8 members, I guess you'd say,
8 dads
at this point.
Yeah.
What if somebody hears this and they're like, man, I want to be a dad at Denim. I got a kid that goes there. I want to support him. I really like this podcast and these guys.
We welcome any dad to be a father to their kid and come out and support their children.
Yeah.
Right.
So being a dad's at Denim is not being a part of this 8 group.
Yeah.
Being a dad's at Denim, be out there, get you a tent next to ours Yeah. And let's make it bigger.
Yeah.
That's being a dad's of denim, right? Yeah,
that's right.
I mean, supporting your kids. Come out, hang out. If you want to help us, I get it all the time.
Yeah.
You wouldn't imagine, you couldn't fathom the messages. What do I need to do to help? Just come.
Yeah.
Just and come that's and help.
What a lot of people want to
show
do.
Up they and, like what show you're up doing and help. Help. And that's fine.
Yeah.
Just pull up. I mean, pull up, park your car, come help. Because I promise you, we can use some help sometimes.
Absolutely.
You know, it's a lot. And, sure and it is. So if you want to be a dad's of denim, just come on.
There you go.
It's not, it's.
Well, we always talk about it too, because it takes the burden off of one or two of us that say Ricky's working on Saturdays.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I got a gig, something like that. We're playing or whatever. We got other dads that coach baseball. So we at least have four guys in mix.
Yeah.
So it helps out. So if there's someone else who wants to come in, we always talk about that we have a general committee of dads of denims, and then we have the elected officials, if you
that's right.
call us that, for the voting purpose.
Because we vote.
Yeah.
See, you don't, a lot of people don't know this, is we'll get together. There's been many a late nights at my house. Right? On the patio. I'm talking about 4 or 5 in the morning late nights.
Woo! Better be some beer involved in those late
nights. I plead the fifth.
Yeah.
So, mic drop. So, we have talked about everything, and there's been so much more we could have done that we decided we wasn't, because it wasn't a good, the counselor says, oh, this is not good for our look.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
I mean, come to a bachelorette party in Arkansas. I said, are you kidding me? You know, it's funnier than you think. I mean, this week we have a meeting with someone with Our Lady of Lake Thursday at 7:30, because they want us to do some stuff for St. Jude.
Man, that's fat. So that's huge.
Things,
that's
fantastic. Things, I mean, we can do so much, but we decide to keep it where we can all do it. Right? Mm-hmm. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Because you can't be everywhere.
Right.
We don't get paid to be a dad of denim.
Yeah.
We still got to work. So
that's right.
At the end of the day, council's like, look, this is not a good look for us. Right. And, and we all vote. And if we vote to do this car show, that's why it happened. If we vote to give these toys away, we do it. It's pretty cool. Believe it or not.
It's very cool.
You know, we don't let one person run this.
That's
it's
right.
It's
a democracy.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's 8 of us, and 2 of them got half votes, believe it or not.
Yeah. Half and half.
Half and half.
That's,
you know,
one.
Why?
Yeah.
Go. I would love to hear it.
So if you have eight total votes, right. it can run 4-4.
Yeah. Yeah. You either need a 9th person, or you got to give people half.
So we gave some halves.
That's hilarious.
That's how we get to our. Go ahead.
But for them to jockey, one wants 3/4, one wants 1/4, and they always talk, man, I could get 1/4 off that guy, you know. Yeah,
I pay you to get your whole vote. Look, if someone, Ray, if you want to offer me $1,500, I may give you my
half, yeah.
So they show up at a meeting, and they says, and Ray's had these shirts built that says, half votes matter. I swear.
That's perfect.
Yeah, you know, it was funny, man. So, but we do as a group. We get together and we make those decisions on what's right for us. Can't no one tell us what we can and can't do, because we never accepted money.
Yeah, that's true. Yes. Once you do that,
you owe someone.
Yeah. That's a good point. Very good point. Smart.
Well, now,
if you want to end up with that.
I will say this. If you ever want to donate to Dads of Denim, right, I'm going to be 100% honest with you. Any local business that wants to help us, bring it to the school and write the check to Denham Springs High School and tell them to put it in the Dads of Denim account, because we have one with them.
Okay.
And that money will go towards things that we do for the school.
Fantastic.
Like if we decide to buy cleats for every kid, we have an account there that we put our money in.
Well, I just saw y'all did something with, there was a picture with Coach Beard and a big check.
Yeah,
so what was that?
That was money that we raised from the car show.
Okay.
So we gave that to Coach Beard, and we're going to put that stereo system in the school.
Okay.
We're going to put in a new entertainment system for the football games, soccer games. I mean,
that was the money you raised?
Mm-hmm. That's just from the car show. We gave that to them, and all the donations that we get, it's always given to them. We don't have an account. We don't have none of that. So it's going to be made to Denham Springs High School.
Fantastic. And let me tell you guys, you know, one of the most important reasons that I did this particular podcast is I do think there's some misunderstandings or misconceptions of what exactly y'all do, and are y'all welcoming, not welcoming, those sort of, these guys are awesome. You know, I've had a great time on the, you know, today, just laughing with you guys and all that sort of stuff, but it's serious business what you do, and you dedicate your time to it. And it's done out of, as you can see from this podcast, pure love, man. You're not, you know, nobody's getting rich over here cooking jambalaya and all those sorts of things.
You right? Never get rich cooking.
Yeah, yeah.
No, everyone in the sense of the pair should be rich as could be.
Yeah. So you're doing this out of a labor of love and for the community, for the kids, and all those sorts of things. You talked about the toys that y'all have given out. Just had a big giant check to Coach Beard and all of those things. I can tell you as a resident of this community, a guy that has three kids that go to school at Denham Springs High School, thank you very much for your unselfish nature and what you're trying to do for the community. I respect it a lot. And well, I mean,
appreciate that, man.
Well, so I've come to kind of the part of the show where we talk about fun facts, and this is just something, just a little bit.
I love this.
Helps people get, yeah. So I didn't tell y'all, obviously, these questions beforehand, but they're just fun little questions. We'll start here and go this way. If you purchased a yacht, you would name it what?
My Sunshine.
My Sun, I like it. What'd you name it? Thunderstorm?
No. A yacht. Okay, a yacht. That's a cool question. A yacht, I would name it Blessed.
Blessed. Very good.
Like it.
Very good. I like it too. Dream job when you were 12.
Wow.
What'd you want to do? Larry Zonka.
Yeah. Maybe run behind him.
Yeah. That's right.
Dream job at 12. Wow. That's a good loaded question. Yeah. I don't know, man. Well, let's see. I started playing music when I was 14, so I guess to run off and take David Lee Ross' job in Van Halen.
Yeah, that ain't bad.
Jump.
Yeah.
as well jump.
I was dreaming at 12 years old to be a finance manager for Ralph Seller Chevrolet.
That's amazing. Oh, and wow. Look what you look at.
Now he's 13.
Hey, I plugged that perfect right there.
You did good.
Mine was this, man. I was an Oakland A's fan. Bash Brothers.
Oh,
Jose
yeah.
Canseco. Mark McGuire. Yeah. My dream was to play in the pros and catch. That was probably 12 years old. I got a little piece of baseball when I went to the Little League World Series, and then the following year we went to Babe Ruth World Series.
Excellent.
So I wanted to get to that point. You know what I mean? I wanted to. I'm sorry, not Little League, Babe Ruth World Series.
Yeah.
And, was that at the LSU, the Ag Center?
No, let me tell you.
That pastor got me on a one hop. I lost that.
So, look, we go to St. Francisville, play district. Then we play state in Abbeville. Then we go to Santa Fe, New Mexico, and spend 11 days. We win that tournament. Ready for the World Series, right? It's in Houma, Louisiana this year. Mm. That year, we all go to Houma. Hurricane Andrew cancels the whole thing.
Bam. Yeah.
Boom. I quit. Mic drop. Baseball's over for me.
Yeah.
No, but that's what I wanted to do, dream job. Go ahead.
Excellent. If you could have any superpower, what would it be?
Oh, wow. A bigger paddle to keep these guys in line.
I got it. I know exactly. I've always asked this question.
To me or to you?
To myself.
Oh, so you got your answer on superpower?
Yeah.
All right. Let's go ahead. You go ahead with it.
Be invisible.
Oh, that's mine.
No,
wow. Same thing. Invisibility.
You still leave footprints.
Oh, I would love it.
You everybody, still leave most, footprints, though, man.
Most people say, I want to fly. I want to be invisible. You never know I was there.
That's right. That's right. I'd be going up on conversation. I knew it.
You know, you ever heard that? I want to be a fly on the wall? That would be if you was invisible.
Agreed.
True.
Agreed.
All right, so give me one. You want to fly?
Do I want to fly? I flew last week to the Bahamas. Right.
Yeah, he flew to the Bahamas to take care of those kids on graduation week. Thank
story
God.
Story for another day.
Dad's Denim was in the Bahamas.
Dad's Denim was there.
Dang.
I had 35 kids with me and eight wives, including my own.
Bless you.
So, yeah, I had to go bodyguard the kids, and it was fun. The kids were good. I'll give them that. But
very good.
Yeah, it was exciting.
Very good.
But I don't know.
Keeping track of all them crazy wives, that's the problem. You know how that gets.
Oh, they were worse, Shoppers downtown in Nassau, man. It was a wild time.
I was at home
working. So I needed a superpower to be a super dad.
See, if he was invisible, you'd have known really what was going on.
I wouldn't have to pay that $1.25 bus fare.
That's right.
Free ride.
Okay, if you could travel anywhere in the world, where would you go?
Anywhere in the world, where would I go? Again, I just left the Bahamas. That was pretty good. But yeah. I'd like to go back to homelands, Italy and stuff like that. You know, I'm three-quarter Italian. Yeah. That's where the height came from. But, I would think around Italy.
And the great hair, by the way.
Thank you, sir. Yeah. Appreciate that. Yeah, little white up guys.
He has good hair, too, though. Yeah. I feel
baby.
Very follically challenged right now in this room.
Look, as soon as he
apparently
said,
I'm the only one stressed.
What did he say? He said, I had a boss cut. I was thinking, well, they messed it up.
Yeah.
They cut it completely off.
Wow.
No, this is Boss when he's 50.
You know where I want to go? I want to go to Alaska. Believe it or not.
It's beautiful.
I want to go there and fish.
I actually have been there, and I will tell you, beautiful. And I ain't a world traveler by any means, but I have been to Alaska.
Right. It's
a beautiful country. I pick, Ireland is somewhere I've never been. Ireland. It just looks beautiful, that would be man. Cool. Mm-hmm.
Go over there and drink some proper 12.
Proper 12, yes.
Proper 12.
Proper 12. Yes.
Some Conor McGregor.
Yes,
stuff.
Mate. So, again, I appreciate both of y'all for coming on. Let's show some support, listeners, for these awesome dads right here, the Dads of Denim. Thank you for coming on. For people that want to get more information, check out what y'all are doing, maybe follow you. Where? Shout out your Facebook.
So we have Tailgates. It's called Tailgates Dads of Denim. Also on Instagram, Tailgates Dads of Denim, and then TikTok.
Oh, you got a TikTok, bro?
We got a million views, bro.
Come on TikTok.
We got 40,000 followers and over a million views.
You know, I fought TikTok forever because I'm like, that's for kids. I ain't getting on that. Man. But I'll tell you what, it's
man, you get legit. On TikTok and you start swiping, you will fall into a hole that you have never been into before.
I stay out of the hole. I'm on the rim watching them down
there. Down there and I'm like, Kessler, pull me out of this hole. TikTok hole, you get caught up in that for 3 hours. You know, if you watch it too long, a little guy comes up and says, you need to take a break. You've been watching too long.
No kidding.
Yeah.
I've never filling that hole.
You go get that hole one day and just say, Dad's a Denim told me about that.
Yeah. Well, check them out.
Yeah. Check us out, please.
Yeah. Facebook, Instagram, TikTok. And we're going to link all of that to the description of this video so it'll make it easy for you to find. I do want to thank everyone out there for viewing and listening to Local Leaders, a podcast. Please continue to like, comment, subscribe, and share a spotlight on Local Leaders by sharing it on all your social media platforms. Now, I want to mention LOPA. LOPA is the Louisiana Organ Procurement Agency. Local Leaders of the Podcast is partnered with Real Life Real Crime, a podcast by Woody Everton, as well as Captain Duvall of Duvall's Cajun Charters to offer a fishing trip for two with Woody Everton. This inshore trip will come complete with a book room in Delacroix, Louisiana. A fishing charter the next morning with Duvall's Cajun Charters, and you'll be fishing with Real Life Real Crime host Woody Everton, as well as 225-quart Yeti ice chest, courtesy of Local Leaders of Podcast, and another donated by our friends at Home Key Mortgage of Denham Springs. It's worth thousands of dollars, this package. $15 for raffle tickets or a book of 10 for $100. You can get those at Beauty Barn Nutrition in Denham Springs. So thanks to all those folks. Thank you to all our sponsors, Trisha Johnston Realtor, BJ Pawn, Big Mike, Sports Bar and Grill, Sporting Center, Black Sheep Creative, SR Enterprise Painting, and William Waldrop of TWFG Insurance. We could not do any of this without all of you. And lastly, we want to tell you to check us out on our new TikTok we're going to have coming out.
No,
there'll be an announcement for that coming up soon. Shortly. I'm going to fall in a wormhole I'll never get out of. Until next time, I'm Jim Chapman reminding you, love your community, support local business, check out our boys over here at the Dads of Denim, and keep leading. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks, Jim.